Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are going to look at a bit on pay of table, which will help you for your exam, right? The question that you are looking at right now is from Kaplan Resource. It is called Ticket Agent. Ticket Agent. If you look at the requirement, you can see that it is asking you a number of things lah. One of the things that I have mentioned in the class is that the question may not ask you indirectly, sorry, may not ask you explicitly what you need to do. For instance, the expected demand here is something that should be quite clear, right? In the sense that you will have to use the probability. And the reason for that is because it tells you expected demand. Okay. And then the next one is this. Question asks you the level of his purchases of tickets per concert that will give him the largest profit. Okay. When we read the question later, okay, you will have, as usual, two things. Lah. Number one, your decision. Before I continue reading the question, eh. Is to calculate the second thing ni. Okay, in your exam, you have, or in your risk and uncertainty question like this, you have decision and outcome. So in this question, your decision actually is the level of purchases. You are the agent. You are the agent. You will buy the ticket and then the tickets are not for you. You will sell the tickets to the customer. But you do not know how many customers that will buy the tickets. So you have to decide, you nak beli berapa. Okay, so the question asks you to calculate the level of his purchases. In other words, how many tickets you have to purchase. And then that will give him the largest profit over a long period of time. That will give him the largest profit over a long period of time. In this case, the keyword is over a long period of time. So if it is over a long period of time, actually it is asking you for an expected value. Expected value, later when we look at the question, there are many different levels of purchases. Which level is the best? Let's say you have three decisions, can which decision is the best based on expected value? How do I know that we have to use expected value? Again, it is not explicitly mentioned, but the word over a long period of time in the exam, if you have such word or such phrases, or let's say you use the word if you assume you do it repeated times, can so usually you repeat mestilah dia jangka masa tu panjang kan. If you do it once, then sekejap je lah, sekali je lah. But over a long period of time, but it also means is that you don't do it once. Dia bukan one off. Kan? You do it many times. So in this case, kita boleh dapatkan probability. Can I told you in the class, that's how you calculate probability. That's how you estimate probability. Again, I repeat for the last time. What the question is asking is to find the expected value. So given different level of purchases, which one has the highest expected value, those will be chosen by you. But in this question, how do you calculate the expected value? You have to do it by preparing a payoff table. That is the main thing that you need to do in this question. You have to calculate what is your decision. And to do that, you need your payoff table. Before I go and read the scenario, the question, you have to know that the payoff table will need to be used in the second question. Calculate the number of tickets using maximin, maximax, and minimax regret. So you can see the pattern, kan? A, when you use EB, what's your decision? B, when you use maximin, what's your decision? And then maximax and then minimax regret. Okay, so the thing is that all these four will need a payoff table. But again, the focus for this recording is to help you prepare better on how do we construct a payoff table. Let's look at the question now. It's not that long, but you have to be really careful about it. I've prepared the Excel table here. So you will see later because we have three decisions and three outcomes. That's why we have nine possible expected value lah. Well, not, sorry, not expected value, the profit. The profit. Let's read the question first. It says a ticket agent has an arrangement with a concert hall that holds concerts on 16 nights a year, whereby he receives discounts as follows per concert. You have to remember, this recording is not meant to discuss the entire question. I only want to help you again better prepare for your payoff table. Okay, our focus is on the payoff table. And by the way, there are not only three but four. Before the concert starts or before the year starts, kan? Katakanlah 2023 nanti ada concert lah 60 kali. Tapi you tak tahu berapa orang nak beli tiket tu. So tahun ni sebelum tahun depan punya konsert tu, sebelum tahun depan, tahun ni kita dah decide dah kena beli siap-siap. Kita tak boleh beli during the event lah, katalah cerita macam tu kan. So there are four decision. So I think I'll make it like this. If I want to put decision like that, kan, as your column, okay, as your column, and outcome will be this row. So you have 200, 300, 400 and 500. Okay. So 200, 300, 400 and 500. Okay. And then there is also one thing that you have to remember here. What you see here in percentage is not the probability. Can I told you that when you see some numbers with percentage, it is not necessarily the probability. And in this case, yes, it is not the probability. Rather, it is a discount. What do you mean by a discount? In this case, macam you jadi agent kan, kalau macam you nak jual barang, satu barang harga dia 100, tapi you beli barang ni bukan untuk you, you beli untuk jual. So kalau you beli pada harga discount 20%, maknanya you beli pada harga 80, but bila you jual dekat customer, customer bayar you 100, betul tak? So the discount when you buy, the discount when you buy actually is your commission. I hope you understand that. Harga dia yang kita akan jual kepada customer dan yang sepatutnya supplier jual ada 100. Tapi bila kita beli daripada supplier, sebab kita agent kan, kita beli pada harga discount. Discount tu sebenarnya kita punya commission, kita punya profit lah. Kan, kita beli pada harga $80, but when you sell it at $100, so $20, yang ni 20% tu is our profit, our commission. So you can see kan, this is the logic of it. A supplier tu, concert punya organizer ke apa, of course dia nak kita beli lagi banyak sebab dia dapat secure revenue awal-awal kan. In other words, the more we buy, the more profit they give us, the more commission they give us in the form of discount. I hope that should be clear. Tapi tak payah kacau lagi lah kat sini, nanti kita nak pakai. The purchases must be in full hundreds. Maknanya kalau kita beli, ini kita lah ni, kita bukan customer. Kita bila kita beli tiket tu as an agent, tak boleh beli 220, tak boleh. It must be in hundreds. And then the average price per ticket is $30. So this is important because you want to apply discount on it later. He must decide in advance each year the number of tickets he will purchase. If he has any tickets unsold, okay, this is not important. You would know that later when we look at our payoff table, this is our decision, kan? Based on our decision, what will be the outcome, kan? Okay. So there will be three situations later, one, two, and three. Ini yang sebenarnya I nak you guys focus for your exam nanti. This one, eh? Tapi I baca dulu soalan so that you understand the question better. If he has any tickets unsold by the afternoon of the concert, he must return them to the box office. If the box office sells any of these, he receives 60% of their price. His sales records over a few years show that for a concert with extremely popular artists, he can be confident of selling 500 tickets. For one with lesser known artists, 350 tickets. For one with relatively unknown artists, 200 tickets. Zaman ini outcome sekarang. Kita beli tiket dulu tetapi kita tak tahu berapa yang akan terjual, kan? So dia dah bagi tiga kemungkinan, sama ada 500, 300.5 atau 200. At this point again, you boleh ikut kecil ke besar ataupun ikut je ke besar kecil pun tak ada masalah. Baik, kata kalau I want to make it like kecil dulu baru besar. Ada. Ingat eh, this is outcome and this is decision. In the exam boleh tak you letak outcome yang dekat atas? Boleh, tak ada masalah. But in my case, I want to make it column. Column E, column F, column G. Macam tu kan. And then outcome tu yang I buat row 3, row 4 and row 5. Kan, 200, 350 and 500. Kan? Macam tu. Okay, and actually you would have one more thing lah here. You would have your probability lah. Probability. Again, that's not my focus for today. Probability kan, 45, 30, ni kena be careful sikit lah. Macam tadi kan, 500, 350 and 200. So 500 ni yang 45, 350 ni yang 30, 200 ni yang 25. Tapi bila I dah buat terbalik kat sini, I kena adjust lah. 500 yang last ni, dia 45. Tu something to know lah kan, something to be careful about. 45%, 30% and 25%, 30% and 25%. Again guys, what is this? This is probability, so it should total up to 100 or it should be equal to 1. Okay, settle kat situ. Again, now, dah habis eh? Dah habis? Macam mana kita nak buat payoff table ni? I want you to listen carefully. because this is again going to help you for your exam. In section C, yeah, this is a section C question. So you have your decision and you have your outcome. So there will be 12 different situations nanti, betul tak? Sama ada you beli 200, nak beli 200, yang nak beli tu 200 juga. Atau you beli 200, tapi yang nak beli tu lagi lagi banyak daripada apa yang you ada, atau 500, macam tu kan? So, okay, I just want to tell you something here. Let me color it yellow. 200, 200, 300 ni tak ada, 500, 500. Okay, there will be in your exam three situations, if not more. Eh? The first one is that your decision is exactly the same with your outcome. You beli 200 dan yang nak beli nanti 200 juga. Right? This is like a an ideal situation. Tapi tak semestinya paling tinggi dari segi profit. Kan? So, you beli 200, decision you 200, outcome you 200. Ini yang pertama. Tetapi boleh jadi dua situasi lagi. Dua situasi lagi. Iaitulah let me color it, let's say orange. Eh, bukan kat sini. Which is, if you buy 300, tetapi yang nak beli tu sikit. Maknanya ada benda yang unsold. Boleh nampak tak kat situ? You beli 300, tetapi yang nak belinya sikit. You beli 300, tapi yang nak belinya sikit. Let me make it like that. Let me change the color. So ini adalah decision is more than outcome. More tu maknanya kita beli lagi banyak daripada outcome nanti. So ini I kata akan ada unsold lah. Ada unsold. Okay, contohnya beli 300, orang nak beli 200. Beli 400 dan 500 kan? All this thing. I make it the same color. Kalau beli 300, okay, ni lebih. Yang ni pun sama. Okay, that is the second situation. And the last situation would be your decision is less than outcome. Maksudnya, not enough. So, not enough apa dia? You beli 200 tiket, tapi yang nak beli 300.5. Nampak kan? Decision lower than berapa yang nak beli. Kan? Supply is lower than the demand. Okay? So, I make it a different color. Dalam exam, you don't need to do this color lah. Kan? The coloring ni is just for, to help you for this recording ni. To help you have a clearer perspective. Betul kan? Ni 200. 200, 200. Okay. So, in this case, kenapa I buat macam ni? Sebab I wanna make sure that you really know how to calculate. For the yellow, yellow part kan, itu yang paling senang. Itu yang paling senang. Okay, yellow. Okay, yellow part ni paling senang. Cuma yang you kena be careful adalah berapa yang you beli sebab different amount of tickets will give you different discount. Kan, sekarang kita dah nak start kira profit. Kan payoff table nama dia profit table. So setiap satu daripada 12 ni, ni 4, darab 3 kan ada 12 kan. Setiap satu ni adalah profit ataupun loss lah. So bila kita nak kira, yang kuning ni paling senang. Okay, contoh eh, kalau kita tengok kat sini, 200 tickets. So when you buy 200 tickets, you boleh cari revenue dulu and then tolak cost dia. Kan? Tapi yang paling mudahnya, you anggap for every ticket tu memang you dapat 20% dah. Kan? So, tapi you nak kira 80% lah. 80% tu cost you, betul tak? I hope, okay, I repeat. Bila 20% discount, maknanya bila you beli pada harga 80%. So, itu cost. So, $30 nanti minus yang 80%, you dapatlah 20% kan? Tapi nak cepatnya ambil 20% terus lah. I hope you understand that eh. So, the first one, this one, you akan dapat apa? You akan dapat 200 tiket tarap dengan 30. 30 tu dolar. Satu tiket harga $30. You beli 200 dan memang 200 yang terjual. Therefore, you akan dapat your profit ataupun in this case, tentunya contribution lah kan. Contribution adalah 0.2. Settle. Okay. What about 500? You beli 500 tiket. Multiply by every ticket $30 revenue tapi kena tolak 0.6. Dia punya ni. Percentage berbeza kan? 40%. So, bila 40% discount, maknanya 60% cost dia. Cost dia 60%, 40% tu duit you kan. I hope this is clear. I'm actually doing a shortcut here. Okay. So, darab dengan 0.4. Nah, macam tu. Okay, boleh. Itu settle. Itu yang senang. Okay. Now, yang senang juga adalah bila you don't have enough. Yang biru ni, you don't have enough. 200 kan? Tapi yang nak beli 300 setengah. Maknanya ada ada yang tak cukup. 200 you ada, yang nak beli 300 setengah. So lagi 150 tak boleh beli kan? If you read the question, yang tak beli, tak boleh beli, tak boleh beli tu tak ada masalah pun. Tak ada masalah. Betul tak? Sebab bukan dia kata bila tak boleh beli, kita tak boleh beli, kita kena denda and so on, tak ada. Therefore, kita sebenarnya copy lah yang atas tu kan, atau 200 darab dengan 30 darab dengan 0.2. Ini kita punya discount atau commission. So sebenarnya dia sama. Dia sama. Ini settle. In other words, kalau sama demand dengan outcome, tak ada masalah. Kalau demand kurang daripada outcome, maknanya outcome yang orang nak tu lagi banyak daripada apa yang kita boleh provide, tak ada masalah. Kita ambil je discount berdasarkan apa yang kita beli. Macam tu eh. Berdasarkan apa yang kita beli tu, semua kita dapat dia punya commission. Okay. Yang the most tricky part, and I'm going to end with this. Ini yang the most tricky part. Bila you beli 300, tetapi yang nak beli hanya 200. So tak terjual, ada benda yang unsold. Ini yang you kena be careful. Ini yang kena be careful, and I'm going to end with this. Maybe I tunjuk satu atau dua cara. Bukan satu atau dua cara, satu atau dua contoh. And I'm going to end the recording because I purposely want to make this not too long. Okay, kita ambil yang pertama dulu eh. Katakanlah I letak kat sini working one. Eh, so working one. Working one. Apa yang berlaku? In this case, we purchase 300 tickets. Sold only 200 tickets. Boleh tak faham? Sebabnya ni kita beli 300 tapi yang nak beli hanya 200 lah. Lagi 100 tu tak terjual tau. Tak terjual. Tak sama dengan yang tak cukup ni, tak terjual. Okay. Now, kita buat benda yang senang dulu. Dalam case ni, dalam exam nanti guys, it is good that you slowly try to figure out apa yang berlaku dalam situasi bila ada yang tak terjual. Because bila ada yang tak terjual kan, kita dah beli benda tu, betul tak? You have bought it. Bila you beli ada cost, betul tak? Cost tu, kalau kita jual, cost tu akan customer tanggung. In fact, kita dapat lebih lagi itu profit kita, betul tak? Tapi sekarang kalau you dah beli tapi tak terjual, you dah beli dah, betul tak? So you ada cost. So unsold tu dia bukan jadi tak dapat apa, jadi akan ada cost untuk you pula. Nampak kan? So itu cerita dia. Jadi sekarang caranya untuk soalan ni lah. Untuk soalan ni ada tiga benda yang you kena tahu. First thing first. First thing first. Yang pertama, apa revenue you? Revenue atau profit yang you dapat daripada yang terjual. Tengok eh. You beli 300. 300. Daripada 300, berapa yang terjual tu? 300 ke tak? Only 200 sold kan? So yang you dapat adalah equal to 200. Again, jangan keliru. Memang you beli 300 tapi yang terjual sekarang 200. So profit you pun 200 lah. Darab dengan 30 because price per tiket 30 kan? Daripada price per tiket 30 tu, you jangan ambil 200 tiket pula. 200 tiket ni yang terjual. Tetapi bila you beli tu, you kan you beli 300. So your discount bukan 20. Your discount 25. Nampak eh? Outcome to 200. Tapi when you buy it, it's 300 kan? So discount bukan 20 tau. Discount bukan berdasarkan outcome. Discount berdasarkan berapa kita beli. Kita beli tadi 300. Cuma tak terjual 100. Macam tu kan? Okay. So discount you 25. That means commission you 25 lah. Okay. So you multiply by 0.25. Settle. Boleh kat situ eh? So ini profit you. Tapi tak habis lagi. Tak habis lagi. Okay. Daripada sini ada yang tak terjual. Cost of unsold tickets. Apa yang I nak buat ni guys? I nak katanya dalam soalan ni, you kena buat satu-satu. Bukan untuk semua pun kan? Untuk beberapa ni, you kena buat satu-satu. Okay. Cost of unsold ticket adalah equal to berapa tadi? You beli 300 tapi 100 yang tak terjual, betul tak? You beli 300 tapi 100 tak terjual. Tengok eh. Okay, I dah 30 lah sebab cost dia kan 30. Cost dia 30. You beli 300 tapi 200 terjual, settle. Yang tak terjual tu 100. Walaupun tak terjual, you dah beli. You dah beli pada harga $30 per tiket. Tetapi bila dia 300, you beli pada harga 75% dia punya cost. Betul tak? Kena faham eh? 25% ni discount. Okay. So bila you beli harga asalnya $30 with 25% discount, cost you bukan 100% 30 ni. 75% je. Boleh kan? So you darab 75%. Kenapa I darab 75%? Sebab I nak cost dia. Tadi I ambil dia punya 25% sebab tu I nak dia punya profit. Betul tak? Sekarang I ambil lawan kepada profit adalah cost lah. So 75%. If it is not clear, you pause. Ataupun you rewind balik ke belakang ni, dengar balik. Okay, ni cost lah. Cost ni datang dari mana ni? Datang daripada 100 tiket yang tak terjual tapi you dah beli, so ada cost dia. Boleh eh? Okay, again. Last kali, benda ni memang you kena baca dalam exam dan you kena perhatikan satu-satu. Because itu orang faham kan? Tapi ada benda yang tak habis lagi ni. Bila you tak terjual, ada cost, boleh return tak? Dia kata, if he has any tickets unsold, he must return lah. Tetapi ada sambungan dia. If the box office, office macam supplier asal lah, you beli pada dia, you nak pulangkan balik dekat dia kan. If the box office sells any of this, he receives 60% of their price. Maknanya, macam tadi kan, kita beli 300, dapat jual 200. Lagi 100 tak terjual tu, kita boleh return. Yang kita return tu sebenarnya, box office tu nanti akan bagi kita balik some profit of that. Tetapi, katakan tadi 100 yang tak kita jual kan, kita return, kita akan dapat balik 60% of the price lah. So kita happy lah sebab tadi cost kan. Tapi kita dapat balik duit. Cuma daripada 100 tu, ada box office dapat jual semua balik. Ha, kena sambung baca, dia kata, his sales records over a few years show that, no, yang bawah ni. His records show that 10% of the ticket he returns are sold by the box office. Dengar betul-betul eh. Kita dapat jual 200. Lagi 100 tak dijual. Lagi 100 yang tak terjual tu kita return. Kita return. Bila kita return, adakah kita dapat semua duit tu? Tak. Kita dapat 60% of the the ticket punya price tu lah kan, kita dapat. Tetapi daripada 60% tu, bukan semua 100% yang dapat jual. Dia kata yang kita return 100% berdasarkan past data, 10% dia yang box office, kita return dekat box office tu, 10% dia yang dapat jual balik. Nampak tak? So in this case, you kena buat dua benda lah. Number one, so ini adalah ada profit profit from return lah, at least profit from tickets return. Okay, in this case, berapa yang kita return? 100. Daripada 100 tu, hanya 10% je yang terjual, betul tak? Hanya 10%. And by the way, don't forget dia selling price dia, $30. Kan, daripada 100 tu, kalau you bayangkan, you dapat jual semua, pada harga $30, you dapatlah semua tu kan? Tapi tak, hanya 10% saja yang terjual daripada 100 tiket. Dan daripada yang terjual tu, you tak dapat semua 30 tu. Box office bagi you 0.6 je. So, you dapat ini. 180. Last sekali, therefore, dekat working one ni, apa jawapan akhir you? So, your net profit, therefore, ini kena hati-hati. Satu, you ada profit minus your cost tadi. Ni profit tau. Ini cost. And then plus extra profit pula yang you dapat daripada ticket and you return. Teman ni tak adalah burn semua kan. Adalah juga sikit dapat. Cuma 10%. And you dapat, okay, it's still a loss. So ini dia jadi negatif 570 lah. So it is not a profit lah. It is a loss. Okay. Habis. I will give you the answers for this payoff table as well as the question lah. Kan, so that you can try to figure out kan, inilah soalan payoff. When you want to create the payoff table, dia tak senang. Ada sebahagiannya yang senang untuk dikira, as I told you, ada sebahagian yang susah. Let me end this video with this because I have another class. Let's say dalam exam ada 9 ke 12 ni kan. Sebahagiannya takkan you tak tahu langsung kan, mesti you tahu sebahagian at least. Katakan sebahagian macam yang baru tunjuk tadi, you tak tahu guna kena buat macam ni. Ataupun dia terlalu complicated sampai you tak tahu nak buat macam mana kan. Remember design ni dengan betul-betul eh. Selepas payoff table soalan ini, B kan kena buat maximum, 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 maximum. 5 markah banyak guys. Kalau you tak buat payoff table, you can never do maximum, 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 maximum. Nak kata apa ni? Kalau katakanlah dalam case, worst case scenario, teruk macam mana pun, you memang tak boleh buat apa-apa kan. You put any number yang dekat, bukan dekat-dekat mana, jangan letak ini satu, ini dua, ini enam, jangan. Macam tu, kalau ini dalam ribu atau dalam ratus, you taklah ratus-ratus juga. Oh, maknanya main letak je any number. Ya, yeah, letak je any number. Ini worst case scenario, jangan kadang-kadang sengaja buat macam tu pula. Ini kalau memang dah tak boleh nak buat apa dah kan, letak je any number. 5,000 ke 4,000 ke, sebab yang nombor sekitar tu kan. You tak nombor yang macam berdekatan dengan yang you boleh cari tu kan. Kenapa eh? Supaya dengan payoff table tu, you boleh proceed dengan soalan B nanti. I dah pernah bagi tahu kan, own figure rule. You akan dapat, you akan hilang makan lah dekat 11 marks ni, mungkin you dapat 2 atau 3 je lah. Kalau you boleh buat sikit je kan, yang kuning dengan biru ni kan, you akan dapat mungkin separuh je, 5 ke 6 markah. Faham eh? So tak, markah tak penuh lah, tetapi bila you guna payoff table yang sebahagian tu salah, tapi you buat maximum, 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 minimum, maximum, maximum ni using the right method, you akan dapat 5 markah penuh. Tolong guys, faham yang tu, own figure. So ini kalau keluar soalan, payoff table. I repeat eh, kena ada tempat tertentu yang you kena careful, slowly buat. Yang kedua, kalau you tak boleh macam mana pun, please come up with some come up with one payoff table so that you boleh proceed dengan maximum, maximum, maximum. Allahu ta'ala a'lam. I apologize for any shortcomings, but I hope you learn something from this sharing. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.